The eye again. When I say literally no law enforcement agency would take a look, not one public defender has taken a look. Not one law enforcement agent has taken a look. Not one friend has taken a look.
Crime tip or complaint to report, please press 1. For all other inquiries, please press 2.
Hello. Thank you for calling the FBI. This is not a 911 service for taking emergency calls. For emergencies, please call 911.
Si usted desea escuchar este mensaje en español, por favor oprima el número 1.
In a few moments, you will be connected to an operator. This call will be recorded for quality assurance, investigative or other purposes. If you do not wish to be recorded, please hang up and submit your tip online at tips.
I already tried that, you dumbass.
.gov. During this call, you will be asked to provide identifying information about yourself and or the persons about whom you are calling. We use this information to assist in investigating.
Don't fucking lie, you piece of shit.
About your name or other personal information. However, the lack of information may delay or hurt our ability.
Bitch, you ain't gonna investigate shit. You're lazy as fuck.
May be used for authorized purposes.
Fuck you, machine. Put a fucking person on.
Email, hacked email, internet scam, or ID theft. Press 1 to report a tip about a threat to human. Please provide the zip code of the area you are calling from now. One moment while I transfer you to the next available representative. Your call will now be recorded.
Calling the FBI. Can I get your first and last name, please?
My first name is Sean, Shawn. My last name is Schwartz, Schwartz.
And your date of birth?
October 18th, 1980.
And lastly, can I get a good telephone number for you?
Yes, ma'am. It's
alright, so I have Sean, Shawn, Schwartz, Schwartz. Date of birth is October 18th, 1980. And your telephone number is.
That is correct.
Okay. And what crime are you calling to report today?
I'm calling to report on hundreds of crimes that have happened in the last 2.5 years. And the police and FBI, who have not investigated, outright refused, up to and including slandering my name and assaulting me.
Okay, have you reported this information previously?
Ma'am, I have all sorts of information to report. Not one person has actually done anything about it. I need to report on a man named Dalton Crawford, who is threatening my life,
okay,
and a man
sir,
named Justin Ward,
have you reported
who
this with us recently, like, before?
No, ma'am. I've reported part of it, but I've got a lot more to report, and you guys literally haven't investigated any of it. I have bags of evidence.
Sir, just because nobody's getting back to you doesn't mean that it's not being investigated.
Ma'am, I have the evidence with me. Nobody has taken a look at it. Not one FBI agent. Not one police
sir,
officer.
Like I said, just because nobody has gotten in touch with you does not mean the information is not being looked at.
Ma'am,
does
they're not looking at
life
it. I have that information. Nobody has come to take a look at it. How is it that they can
okay,
take
sir,
a look
like
at that
I
information?
Said, just because nobody's been in contact with you doesn't mean it's not being looked at. Who threatened your life?
Well, hundreds of people, ma'am. One of them was named Dalton Crawford. He's friends with a woman named Jody, and her last name is Bollinger, but she goes by Alicia. Her and her family have been threatening me, harassing me, assaulting me, and sending people after me for 2.5 years. Well, ma'am, they threatened to kill me.
What did they say?
I will have to open up my Facebook in order to find that. I was made homeless by the death of Natalie Bollinger, Alicia's twin sister. And my name was slandered across the media and across the whole world, believe it or not. I can't go and see any of my friends or family. And police have gone out of their way not to look at evidence, including threatening, harassing, and intimidating.
Sir, I just need to know how you were threatened. I don't need to know about the slander.
Well, Dalton Crawford said he was going to kill me. The specifics.
When did he say that?
Well, he's said it several times since the death of Natalie Bollinger. Natalie died December 28th of 2017. The exact threat, I don't have it right here in front of me. I would really like somebody to come actually take a look at this stuff. I live in a vehicle.
So
it's all unorganized.
How did he
threaten you? He got a hold of me on Facebook and told me he was going to kill me, along with hundreds of other people who saw the slander.
Why would hundreds of people be threatening to kill you?
Because my name was slandered by the Bollinger family, and then Natalie was killed.
What does Natalie's death have to do with anything?
Well, Natalie's death happened 2 weeks after a protection order that she got that she lied on, and as a result, when she had Joseph Michael Lopez shoot her in the head, people came after me. The police came after me. The public came after me. I was assaulted over 30 times last year over her death. Dalton Crawford is a friend of hers and her sister's. They were among a great many people who were threatening my life and playing head games, and the police absolutely and outright refused to take a look. Every time I tried to get them to take a look, they either threatened me, assaulted me, refused to take a report, or locked me up and forced drugs into me. Yes, police have threatened me. Police have outright assaulted me, ma'am. I've been trying to get somebody to actually take a look at this for 2.5 years. The assaults by the police didn't start until January 6th of last year, and they have done everything in their power not to look at evidence of the things that were happening to me, forcing me into a panic attack and forcing me to do illegal things to try to defend myself. I've been trying to get the FBI to take a look since February 6th or 5th of last year.
So how do you know Dalton Crawford?
I don't know Dalton Crawford. I knew Natalie Bollinger and Alicia Bollinger. C-R-A-W-F-O-R-D.
And Dalton, D-A-L-T-O-N?
Yes, ma'am.
And you said Jody is Natalie's twin sister?
Yes, ma'am. They've been threatening me, harassing me, and... Go ahead.
How do you spell Jody?
J-O-D-I. Although, if you... Go ahead.
Can you spell her last name as well?
B-O-L-L-I-N-G-E-R. Although the last name is...
Do you know either of their birthdays?
I want to say their birthday is February 24th.
Do you know the year?
I do not.
And that's Natalie and Jody's birthday?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Why is Jody threatening you?
She's not. She's having other people threaten me for her. Natalie, her twin sister, was suicidal, so she asked me to go to Virginia to see her, and I wasn't there fast enough. She told me that if I wasn't already on the road, she was going to kill herself. A couple hours later, she tried, so I drove all the way to Virginia. Her and her sister invited me to go to a lot of places, and we had a lot of fun. But I had a severe panic attack on my birthday. A lot of people had done a lot of really messed up things. They had given me a phone that wouldn't work. It was calling people on its own. It was sending messages on its own. It was my first smartphone. Anyway.
So, sir, I'm confused as to why these people are threatening you. Why is Jody having people threaten you?
Well, ma'am, she blamed me for her sister's death. See, got an email from Natalie in 2016 detailing her dad raping her, or her dad molesting her and trying to beat her mother to death and her stepmother and things like that. Basically, when I was in Virginia, I got my car stuck in the road while I was severely dehydrated. They interpreted that as me threatening them, and then they went and told a whole bunch of people who were on meth in Boulder, which is where I knew them from, that I had threatened their family. I hadn't.
Why would they take that as a threat, that your car was stuck?
Well, I was in the middle of the road on South Military Highway in Chesapeake, Virginia. A car narrowly missed me, and I honked my horn so that people wouldn't run into me. They took that as a threat.
Who took that as a threat?
Natalie's parents, or Natalie's mother in specific, and Jody as well. That's the thing, is that it's a really
fucked... Why would they take that as a threat? Were they the ones driving the car?
No, ma'am, I was the one driving the car. I had gone over to talk to Natalie because the phone wasn't working, and the phone had created quite a rift between us because it was doing its own thing. Now, Jody Bollinger can verify all of this, but I have to get her in court. However, the police did everything they could to prevent me from going to court and showing evidence. They even stole evidence repeatedly.
Sir, I'm not following you. I don't understand why your car being stuck in the middle of the road would be threatening to them.
Well, see, that's the thing. It doesn't matter why. It matters that they actually did it. They spread rumors that
they
I was threatening them. They spread rumors that I was threatening them because my car was stuck in the road. Now, you not understanding it doesn't matter. I don't understand it either. I do understand why they would take that stance. I mean, you've got some dude who's stuck out in the middle of the road honking his horn as a mother... You know, her mother's name is Rose M. Kelly. As a mother, yeah, that would probably freak her out a bit. Natalie was afraid of her mother's opinion.
Were they there? Were the Bollingers there?
They were in their house, yeah. I mean, I typed into MapQuest.
You were outside of their house?
I was. Well, I had typed in their address in MapQuest because I was going over there to talk to them about the telephone. But when I got there, my vehicle broke and my... I thought it was power steering, but the guy who I got the car from, his name is David Nelson. He told me that it's the attachment between the steering wheel column and where it goes into the floorboard. So I was able to get it fixed. But the fact is, they spread rumors because of that. And those rumors went to Maddie Boa, who was supposed to go there with me. Maddie Boa is a meth dealer. She wasn't able to go with me because she got busted selling meth. And... the rumors
Can
that
spell
they
her name for me?
M-A-D-I-B-O-A.
B-O-A, D as in David, O-A?
No, Boa as in Boa Constrictor. She's a snake.
Okay.
Anyway, she's a lesbian and she wanted the set. And as a result, when I left Virginia, because they took things so incredibly wrong, I left Virginia to get away from them, to go see my friends and family in Boulder and to heal up. But when I got to Boulder, the rumors got there before I did. At first, it was that I had stalked some girl in Virginia, and then later on, the rumors had adapted into I had raped some girl in Virginia. And then it adapted to I had molested some girl in Virginia, and people were threatening me and assaulting me, and I couldn't get the police to take a report, not in Chapel, Nebraska, not in Boulder, Colorado, and they were harassing me over the internet as well. So, with police unwilling to help, the only thing that I could do was try to appeal to those young women to come forward and tell the truth. And they absolutely were unwilling. They sent people after me, people like Dalton Crawford, and one of the other ones, his name is Tim Beeson. These people have been... B-E-E-S-O-N.
Okay, so essentially people are threatening you because this Natalie committed suicide, and then her sister Jody spread rumors that you... stalked her, raped her, and molested her.
No, not exactly. Her sister didn't start those rumors. Her sister lied outright and said that I had stalked them to Virginia. Natalie was not dead when the rumors started. Natalie died a year after the rumors started because I had to try to find a law enforcement agent to actually do their job and to do something about the threats and harassment against me. These people were stalking me, and they wouldn't do a goddamn thing.
So this has been occurring since 2016?
Yeah. The first threats were in October of 2016.
All right, sir, I have enough information here, and I'm going to get this documented, okay?
Thank you, ma'am. I got hundreds more people, so I'll be calling you guys a lot. You be safe.
Okay, you have a nice night.
Yes, ma'am.